Hi there. My name is Gary Barnett. I'm a student here, a PhD student in historical musicology, and I'm very excited today to begin my instruction on the University of California Riverside Carillon, as you can see behind me. And in just a few minutes, my teacher, Professor David Christensen, our Carilloner here, is going to give me my lesson. Looking forward to it.
Oh, hi, Gary.
Hello.
I'm David Christensen.
Nice to meet you. Long last.
Yeah, I understand you've signed up to take Carillon lessons this quarter.
I have, yes. Okay. It's, yes.
Okay, well, I know you're a little bit nervous probably about it, being the first lesson and all, but let's go ahead and go on up to the tower. I think this is going to be a lot of fun this quarter, and I'm looking forward to it.
Myself included.
Okay, well, let's go on up.
Thank you.
Gary, we have an elevator in the tower, but there may be times when we need to take the stairway, so let's take the stairs today to go up. Are above us, so what I'm going to need to do is open up this door in the roof here so that we can hear as we're playing. So we'll open it up just a little bit and let some of the sound into the room. Gary, why don't you come over here to the console and have a seat on the bench.
Okay,
does that feel comfortable to you? Are you pretty much, you want to be sure that the bench is the right height and that you're close enough.
Seems all right.
Okay.
Kind of like this here, is that about
right? Yeah. We won't be using the pedals here quite yet. We'll do that a little bit later as we progress. So I'm going to start you off with this instruction book here from the Netherlands Carillon School.
That's cool. I've been there. Amsterdam? Yeah, that's great.
Amersfoort.
Amersfoort, okay.
Let's start off here on page 25.
Okay.
And let's have you do a couple of these first exercises here, just to kind of get familiar with the feel of the instrument.
All right. So
you're
just
playing in thirds here. So
just double thirds?
Yeah, yeah. I'm going to be right here, starting off in the center of the keyboard.
All right. Here we go.
Okay. Now, your arms are a little bit rigid there, and you're starting off too far away from the keys. So let's have your hands actually in contact with the keys so that rather than a feeling of hitting the keys, it's going to be more feeling of pressing the keys down, and you'll have more control.
So
just relax a little bit and let's try it one more time.
Okay,
now that's probably a little bit too much wrist movement.
I see. Somewhere in between.
Yeah. One of the reasons you want to keep in contact with the keys is because with the Carillon you can achieve a great dynamic range. So, you know, if you're playing up striking like this, you're not going to be able to have control over your dynamics.
I see.
So, see, and now
I get really close. And
you'll be able to achieve, you know, just as you would at the piano. So, I think in some ways you'll find this similar.
I see.
As far as being able to have an expression with your dynamics.
Can I try that? Maybe I'll do a crescendo to the top of the line and decrescendo down?
Let's try that.
Try the first time.
Yeah,
all right.
Yeah.
Okay.
very nice, very nice. You're achieving much more control.
To the end of this lesson,
I think we've had a good first lesson.
Yeah.
And to end up with today, let's have you play this little piece here, just to give you something familiar to end up with today. So go ahead and try this one. This will kind of incorporate some of the techniques and things we've talked about today.
Okay.
You can see there's a few more variations on the piece that I'm not going to put you into the position of sight reading right now. So, well, we'll let you work on that during the week for the next time. But there is one other thing I want to introduce you to for you to work on for the next lesson.
Okay.
Once in a while, there's a technique where you're going to be playing two notes with one hand. So, for instance, on this piece down here, and I'm glad you like that melody you just had, because now you're going to do it again.
Yeah,
so,
okay.
So, with this piece, you're going to be using the right hand to play two notes as you play the melody and bring out the melody in the left hand part.
Looks tricky.
Well, let's have you try it.
Yeah, all right.
I think you'll do okay.
It's going to spread apart.
Yeah.
So I just I hold the two hands with my fingers like that or something?
Yeah, use the thumb on the lowest note and then
two fingers.
Four, the top note there as you play the thirds.
Is that what they call fingering?
Go into the fourth too. Well, we call it handling on the Carillon.
Handlings?
Yeah.
All right, let's see if I get a handle on that.
Okay. All right.
And I have to voice the left hand louder.
Well, you want to be sure the melody is heard there.
Okay.
So.
Is it all right if I just do this hand separately just for a second?
Sure,
the feel of it?
Sure.
That one's a fourth.
Yeah. Don't worry quite as much about the dynamics right now.
I see. Just
as you get used to it. You know, you'll have time to practice it during the week.
Yes.
So this is just to introduce you to it.
Yeah, I don't even know if I can do it hands together. But I got the concept.
That's okay. Okay. We'll do that. Work on it during the week for next time.